channel of Analyst IAS. So our today's topic for discussion is the Forest Amendment Bill of 2023. ये लोक सभा में प्रेजेंट हुआ है. So we'll see why news, background क्या है इस Forest Act का. After that key highlights देखेंगे बिल के, क्या new recommendations है. Then we'll see some arguments in the favor of the bill, criticism or the arguments in against of the bill. Then we'll be solving our today's prelims practice question, which would be based on this topic. So let's start. First via news, recently government ne introduced kiya hai Forest Conservation Amendment Bill 2023 in Lok Sabha and changes proposed kiye hain Forest Conservation Act of 1980 mein. Jo aim hai proposed changes ka, it is to build forest carbon stock by raising plantations. The bill also seeks to make land available for compensatory afforestation. Yeah, all technical terms we'll understand them. Now background of the issue is, after independence vast areas of forests jo the they were designated as reserved and protected forests. However, bahut se aise forests the jo left out ho chuke the and the areas without any standing forests were included in the forest lands. Now there was a case TN Godavarman Thiru Mulpad versus Union of India case. इस केस में कोर्ट डायरेक्टेड दैट जो फॉरेस्ट है इट विल नॉट ओनली इंक्लूड फॉरेस्ट जो डिक्शनरी सेंस का है बट इसके अंदर कोई भी एरिया विच इज रिकॉर्डेड एज फॉरेस्ट इन द गवर्नमेंट रिकॉर्ड इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द ओनरशिप पब्लिक और प्राइवेट दैट वुड बी कंसिडर्ड एज फॉरेस्ट. हाइलाइट्स अगर हम बिल के देखें जो प्रपोज हुआ है, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल प्रीएम्बल इंट्रोड्यूस किया जाएगा एक्ट में. इट प्रपोजेस टू इंसर्ट अ प्रीएम्बल टू द एक्ट to encompass the country's rich tradition of preserving forest, their biodiversity, tackling them climate change challenges within its ambit. So ek preamble dene ki koshish hai. Then the bill adds more activities to this list, jaise ki zoo and safaris under the Wildlife Protection Act of 1972, which would be owned by government or any authority in the forest areas other than the protected areas. Ecotourism facilities badhai jayengi. Then there is silvicultural operations. It means enhancing the forest growth than any other purpose specified by the central government. So these activities are there in the list. Then land under the purview, the bill provides two type of land provide karta hai which will be under the purview of the act. First is land declared notified as the forest under the Indian Forest Act of 1927 or under any other law. Then second is land jo cover nahi hai is first category mein but is notified as a forest on or after October 25, 1980 in a government record. Exemption kuch categories mein isme diye gaye hain. It exempts the following forest land from obtaining prior forest clearance. Those are forest lands with a distance of 100 km along the international borders or the LOC to be used for construction of strategic linear project. Then aise forest jo rail line ya public road ke aas paas hote hain which are maintained by government. Then tree plantations on the private lands that are not categorized as forests. So इनके लिए prior forest clearance से इनको exempt किया गया है. Aim जो है वो है ये है कि fast track and strategic security related projects जो national importance के हैं वो जल्दी बन जाएंगे. It also provides access to small establishment, habitations, public road or railways के around. Moreover, ये encourage करेगा plantations को non-forest land पे. Power to issue directions. So bill adds that the central government may issue directions for the implementation of the act to any authority, organization under recognized by the center, state or union territory. So government can issue any directions. Then uniformity, ye ek uniformity lata hai in the applicability of the provisions of the act with respect to the government and private entities. So ek uniformity laega hai government or private entities ke applications mein. Then condition for non-forest purposes activities. It also empowers the central government to specify conditions subject to which any survey such as reconnaissance, prospecting, investigation or exploring including seismic survey shall not be treated as non-forest purposes. Now what is the aim of the bill? Agar hum aim dekhenge, so to build forest carbon stock by raising plantations to make land available for developers to meet their legal obligation towards compensatory afforestation in the lieu of forest land. मतलब अगर उसने कहीं forest land lieu में लिया है तो फिर compensatory उतना या उसके दुगना afforestation को करना पड़ेगा और ये वो plantations भी कर सकता है. So this is the aim of the bill. and to achieve both these objectives by restricting the applicability of the FC Act, Forest Conservation Act, and freeing up the land that is currently locked up as unrecorded forest. Criticism bill ka kya hai? It limits the applicability of the Forest Conservation Act and it was result in fewer projects needing to obtain forest clearance. Kyunki ye bahut asaan ho gaya hai. Forest clearance ek obstacle hota hai government aur private developers dono ke liye. However, ye jo move hai, ye jo naya bill hai, it would make it easier for the developers to obtain forest clearance whenever they require it. Second is ki isme terms jaise proposed ecotourism facilities, any other purposes, ye jo hai, inka misuse ya exploitation kar sakti hai government for the activities damaging the forest and ecosystem in the land. Moreover, ek argument aur hai ki jo plantations are a significant threat to Indian forest, kyunki plantations jo hai, jo isme propose kiye hain, wo natural ecosystem ke liye threat hai. Plantations ekdam alag hota hai, wo soil ki quality ko affect karta hai aur bahut sari cheeze hain. And particularly ye native biodiversity ko bhi ek tarike se threat hoga. Now, all the proposed exemptions, they directly violate the Forest Rights Act of 2006. The bill also limits the application of the Forest Conservation Act to ensure the diversification of forests by the use of public, private sector and advanced indigenous for ease of business. Ease of business ka isme zyada kiya gaya hai taki aasani se ho sake. Now, the bill also violates the Panchayat Act and constitutional provisions for the STs and other traditional forest dwellers jo rehte hain wahan. Ye also attempt karta hai to redefine forest to promote private plantations that can lead to massive deforestation and environmental degradation as well. Now let's discuss our today's prelims practice question that consider the following regarding the Forest Act 2006. It is not applicable to municipal areas. B. It is also applicable to national parks, wildlife sanctuaries and tiger reserves. C. A provision for the conversion of the forest villages to revenue villages has been mentioned under this act. Which of the statements above is correct? You can try to answer it. You can type the answer in the comment section. There I'll let you know if it's correct or not. Second question kehta hai, what type of forest resources are found in the Arabali forest range, which is considered to be the best example of conservation in the West Bengal? Chirpine, sal, khair, ya babool? This was all about today's video and topic. Thank you. Have a nice day and stay tuned with the list IAS for your better preparation.